Property. Today, I am going to start a new topic, that is eighth lesson of our physics, oscillations. Yes. You already know there are three types of motions. Translatory motion, oscillatory motion, and rotatory motion. What is translatory motion? Yes, you know this. Already explained you in my previous classes, in previous lessons also you already learned. Suppose if a body is moving on a straight line, that motion is called translatory motion, or you can say it's a one-dimensional motion. Means suppose if you consider a body for which it contains number of particles in it. Suppose if a body is in the motion, translatory motion means, suppose every particle within the body has the same velocity. So that type of motion is called a translatory motion. Okay. Now what is rotatory motion? So rotatory motion means a body is moving on the circumference of a circle with a constant speed. That is called uniform circular motion. Suppose if the body is moving on the circumference of a circle with variable speed, that type of motion is called non-uniform circular motion. Okay, that means the body can rotate on the base of the axis. That is the axis of rotation which is passing through the center of the body. But of course, that depends on the shape of the body. So in this way, I already explained you about the circular motion. And today, I'm going to explain another type of motion, that is oscillatory motion. What is oscillation? Yes, you know that it is just nothing but a to and fro motion. The body is moving up and down about its mean position. Okay, that type of motion is called oscillatory motion. Okay. Now, we'll learn something, that is some definitions of physical quantities, that is periodic motion. What is periodic motion? Yes. A motion which represents itself in regular intervals of time along the same path is called periodic motion. Okay, try to understand this. A motion which represents itself regular intervals of time along the same path, whatever the types of motion it is, but it represents itself in regular intervals of time along the same path is called periodic motion. That means suppose Earth has a periodic motion. Okay, that means the time taken for one rotation is same, for it is always same at any instant of time, at any cost. So that is nothing but periodic motion. Okay. Now what is harmonic motion? Yes. The periodic motion of the body, which is to and fro along a straight line about a fixed point, is called harmonic motion. Yes. What is harmonic motion? It is a periodic motion of the body which is to and fro along the straight line about the fixed point is called harmonic motion. Try to understand this definition. That means the displacement of the particle in periodic motion repeated by harmonic function. That means we are representing this harmonic motion in terms of sine, cosine functions of the time. Okay. That means the representation is different. Okay, the periodic motion of the body, which is to and fro along the straight line about a fixed point, is called harmonic motion. Okay, that means this harmonic motion we can represent in terms of sine or cosine functions. Right. Very, very important thing is a simple harmonic motion. Shortly, you can say SHM. SHM means simple harmonic motion. What is simple harmonic motion? Yes, a periodic motion in which a body moves to and fro about its mean position is said to be simple harmonic motion. It is a periodic motion in which a body moves to and fro about its mean position is said to be simple harmonic motion. And there is a condition. What is the condition? If its acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement of the body from the mean position, at its directed towards the mean position, suppose if it holds good these two conditions, then only the body is executing simple harmonic motion. Remember, oscillation is quite different from simple harmonic motion. That means we are representing this motion in terms of sine and cosine functions. That is one thing. That is why those are called harmonic motion. Suppose if a body is moving to and fro about its mean position in a vertical path, so that suppose if it holds good to the following condition, that is what the acceleration is directly proportional to its displacement of the body from its mean position, and also it is directed towards the mean position. Okay, the equation is A proportional to minus Y. Remember, suppose if the body is executing simple harmonic motion, means the body should satisfy this condition. What is that condition? Yes, whenever it is moving to and fro motion, it has the velocity changes, you know, the oscillation of simple pendulum. For example, if you consider the oscillation of simple pendulum, you know that a pendulum is a bob is tied with a string for which it is suspended at a point, then the body is executing to and fro motion, means its velocity changes. You know that at extreme position its velocity is maximum, at mean position its velocity is minimum. Then at extreme position its velocity is max. That means there is a change in velocity takes place, means it has an acceleration, isn't it? So that acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement of the body. That is very, very important thing, from its mean position. And always it is directed towards the mean position. Yes. Suppose if it holds good these two conditions, then the body is executing SHM. Simply you can say SHM. That is what? Simple harmonic motion. Try to understand the statement, because it is the heart of this lesson. When you understand the meaning of the simple harmonic motion, so then only, of course, you can understand all the things in this lesson. Okay. Here A is the acceleration, Y is the displacement. Therefore, A proportional to minus Y. Suppose if you want to remove the proportional, you can take A is equal to some minus omega square Y. Okay, omega square is constant. So this is the equation of the SHM. Try to understand. What is SHM? Yes, it's a periodic motion which a body moves to and fro about its mean position is said to be simple harmonic. That means its acceleration is directly towards the mean position. Okay, that means its acceleration is always directly proportional to the displacement. Okay, therefore mathematically you can represent the equation A proportional to minus Y. Yes, conditions for simple harmonic motion, very, very important. What are the conditions for which the body is executing the simple harmonic motion? Of course, the body is having oscillation, but you don't call it as a simple harmonic motion. If it obeys these conditions, for which I'm going to explain. If it obeys those conditions, then only the body executing simple harmonic motion. Remember, okay? Yes, what are the conditions? Yes, motion should be periodic. The body must move to and fro about its main position. Acceleration must be directed towards the main position. Okay. Acceleration must be directly proportional to the displacement. And acceleration and displacement must be opposite to each other. Yes. Very, very important points you should try to understand. Suppose if a body is executing simple harmonic motion, means it should follow these conditions, then only we call that body is executing simple harmonic motion. Okay. What are those conditions? Yes, motion should be periodic. The body must move to and fro about its mean position. Acceleration must be directed towards the mean position. Acceleration must be directly proportional to the displacement. And acceleration and displacement must be opposite to each other. Okay. Suppose if anybody holds good these conditions, then you can say that body is executing simple harmonic motion. That body is in simple harmonic motion. Okay. Understand? There are two types of simple harmonic motion. One is linear simple harmonic motion. What is linear simple harmonic motion? Yes. If to and fro motion is along the straight line, it is called as linear simple harmonic motion. If to and fro motion is along the straight line, it is called linear simple harmonic motion. That means the displacement is measured along the straight line. Okay. Why? Because the body is moving on the straight line from its mean position. Hither and thither. Okay. Left to right. To and fro. So that then that type of motion is called linear simple harmonic motion. And also the displacement is measured along the straight line. Okay. So what are the examples of linear simple harmonic motion? Yes. Oscillation of a simple pendulum with a small displacement. R. Okay. Oscillation of simple pendulum with small displacement. You know the simple pendulum? You know the construction of simple pendulum? Suppose if you suspend a simple pendulum from a support, take one side, some angle, very less angle. If you release the bar, then what happens? It is doing simple harmonic motion. These are to and fro motion. Oscillations takes place. So that these oscillations, that means this to and fro motion is along the straight line for which this motion is called linear simple harmonic motion. Okay. Oscillations have a simple pendulum with small displacement. Yes, it is very, very important. Then only the body, of course, the follow the above conditions in the slide. So whenever the body is follow the above conditions, then the body is at SHM, you can say. Okay. Now another example is motion of a loaded spring when it is stretched and released. Suppose take a spring for which one end is connected to the support and another end is hang with weight. Stretch it and release it. What happens? It is moving up and down. So that type of motion is also called a simple harmonic motion. That means this to and fro motion is along straight line, so that it is linear simple harmonic motion. Okay. Here I am stressing about the conditions and about SHM. Try to understand. The body is oscillating means you don't think that body is at SHM. If it obeys the above conditions, then only the body is at SHM. That is the difference between the oscillations and simple harmonic motions. Okay. Anyway, there are two types of simple harmonic motion. That is, one is linear simple harmonic motion. Yes, I already just explained you that is oscillation of a simple pendulum and motion of a load spring. These two are the examples of the linear simple harmonic motion. Okay. Yes. What is angular simple harmonic motion? Another type of the SHM is what? Angular simple harmonic motion. Yes. If to and fro motion is on circular path, then it is called angular simple harmonic motion. That means the displacement is measured in terms of angles. That is oscillations of freely suspended magnet in Earth's magnetic field. That is the example. Yes. To and fro motion in a circular path, then it is called angular simple harmonic motion. As you know that suppose if you take the magnetic compass, a needle is pivoted at the center, and then you can observe the needle is moving on the circular scale. Okay, so here that from that you can measure the oscillations also. You can observe oscillations also. So that type of oscillations of freely suspended magnet in the Earth's magnetic field is the best example of angular simple harmonic motion. Isn't it? Are you following, students? Yes. Another important physical quantity, that is time period, for which we can represent it by the letter capital T. Yes. What is time period? The time taken for one complete oscillation is called time period. Yes. Suppose take a simple pendulum. Take it to one side and release it. Then what happened? It goes to other side and comes back. That means it makes one complete oscillation. Now measure the time taken to take the one complete oscillation. That is nothing but what? Time period. That is time taken for one complete oscillation is called time period. Okay. Yes. What is frequency? You can represent the letter N. Sometimes also F. Okay. What is frequency? Yes, it is number of oscillations per second is called frequency. As you know that the simple pendulum is executing SHM means the time taken to complete one oscillation is called time period, and the number of oscillations per second is called frequency. And what is amplitude? This also you must know. The distance from the mean position to the extreme point, that is called amplitude. Okay, so where the mean position? Usually at the center. So from the center to the extreme position, that distance is represent the amplitude. Okay, so in this way we should know about these terms, that is time period, frequency, and also amplitude. And also I explained to you about the types of SHM, linear SHM and angular SHM. Okay. Yes. What is phase? It is an angle which represents the state or position of the direction of a particle from its mean position. It represents the phase. Yes. The position of the particle at that particular instant. So that represents the phase of that point. Okay. So then what is the phase? It is an angle which represents the state or position or direction of the particle from the mean position, that is called phase, for which we can represent by the letter phi. It is phi. Okay. It always represents the position and direction of the particle at that particular instant. So that that is called phase. Okay. Epoch. What is epoch? The initial phase of oscillation is called epoch. Where the initial phase at t is equal to 0. So at t is equal to 0, the initial phase, of course, is of oscillation is called epoch. And of course, amplitude. The maximum displacement of a particle from its mean position is called amplitude. Okay. The maximum displacement of a particle from its mean position is called amplitude. I told you. So these are the very, very important physical qualities you should understand and you should remember also. Sometimes it is frequently, these physical qualities will come. That is time, period, frequency, amplitude, epoch, phase. All should be, you know, about these terms. Okay. Yes. Next. Yes, amplitude. So in this lesson, very, very important question is, relation between uniform circular motion and simple harmonic motion. Uniform circular motion and simple harmonic motion. What is the relation? You know uniform circular motion? What is the uniform UCM? Yes, if a body is moving on the circumference of a circle with constant speed, it is called uniform circular motion. What is simple harmonic motion? Yes, the body is moving to and fro motion about its mean position. Okay, then it is called simple harmonic motion, means it should follow the conditions, that is, the acceleration is directly proportional to the displacement, and of course the displacement always directed towards the mean position, so that then only the body is at a simple harmonic motion. Now we are going to observe, that is, relation between uniform circular motion and simple harmonic motion. Very interesting. See, yes, we have to prove that the projection of uniform circular motion on any diameter of a circle exhibits simple harmonic motion. Yes. What is the projection? Yes. Let us consider a particle P is moving on the circumference of a circle. Okay. Just try to understand. Keep concentration on the screen. Let us consider a particle P is moving on the circumference of a circle. Okay. Having radius A with uniform angular velocity omega. It is omega actually. Yes. Draw the two perpendiculars from P on the diameter xx dash and yy dash. Let M and N be the projections on the diameter xx dash and yy dash. Yes. The centripetal acceleration is resolved into two components. Just I'll explain you this. Yes. Now the body, consider a particle is moving on the circumference of a circle. Observe the diagram here. Very clearly, the diagram is represent each and everything. Now, let us consider a particle is moving on the circumference of a circle of radius A with uniform velocity omega. Now, draw the perpendiculars from P on the diameters. Yes, these are the diameters. There are number of diameters actually we are having. We are considering these diameters x, x dash and y, y dash. Okay. Let M and N be the projections on the diameter. Yes. See here, suppose if you draw the projection here, that is from P to the diameter xx dash, the point is N. Yes, that is what? N is the point of projection on diameter xx dash. Projection of what? P. Or you can draw the projection on yy dash also, that is also you can present with letter M. In this way, just take the point of projection of P, a particle which is rotating on the circumference of a circle on the diameters, either on xx dash and yy dash. Okay, here M and N are represent the point of projections of the particle which is rotating on the circumference of a circle. Okay, now the centripetal acceleration is around two components. Otherwise, just you observe this animation diagram here. Here, whenever the red mark, this is a particle which is moving on the circumference of a circle. Now, you suppose if you take the projections on xx dash or yy dash, then what happened in case of xx dash? See that the blue spot is moving to and fro motion. Yes, that means from this diagram, try to understand that the particle P, which is in the red spot, is moving on the circumference of a circle. Suppose if you draw the projections on the diameters, say suppose that here the bottom line is a, of course, xx dash. That blue part is moving on to and fro motion about its mean position. Yes, that means what? the particle pre projection on diameters represents the oscillation, that is simple harmonic motion. Understand? Very interesting here. Here only try to keep concentration on the points, that is point of projection of particle P on the diameters either xx dash or yy dash. That point of projection can move to and fro, that is left to right, hither and thither from its mean position. Yes, that red spot is motion is what? Subtler motion. And blue spot motion is what? Yes, it is simple harmonic motion. Now we are going to take the relation between the uniform subtler motion and simple harmonic motion. Okay. Now, whenever the body is moving on the circumference of a circle, yes, it is a uniform circular motion, means what? Its speed is constant, but velocity is not constant. Why? Because suppose if you take at every spot on the circumference of circle, then its direction changes. Because of the change of direction only, it is moving on the circular path. So that means there is a change in velocity. So whenever the change in velocity, it has what? Acceleration. So when the body is moving on the circumference of a circle, that means its acceleration is always towards the center. That acceleration is called what? Centripetal acceleration. Remember, because on centripetal acceleration, the body is rotating on the circumference of a circle. Try to understand, there is a internal connection. Here I am putting another term, that is centripetal acceleration. Centripetal means it is a force which is always towards the center, that is centripetal force. Of course, it has an acceleration because of the change in velocity, so that because of the change in velocity, it has that acceleration is always directed towards the center. So that is why it is moving on the circumference of a circle. Anyway, don't be confused. You can say that centripetal acceleration is resolved into two components. A is the what? Radius of the sphere. And omega is what? Angular velocity. Remember, in my last class, I already told you that what is angular velocity? Yes, it is rate of change of angular displacement is called angular velocity. We can represent by the letter omega, d theta by dd. You have to recollect all the definitions. Then only you can understand. Okay. So here omega always represents what? Angular displacement. So that the centripetal acceleration is resolved into two components. You know the resolution of a vector. Along vertical direction you can take sine theta, along horizontal direction you can take cos theta. In this way, you can have, yes, as you know that V is equal to R omega. But what is the centripetal acceleration A? A is equal to V square by R. But V is equal to R omega, R square omega square by R. Here I mention all these things in brackets. V is equal to R omega, you know. What is V is equal to R omega? Linear velocity is equal to radius into angular velocity. This also I proved in my last class. That is the relation between the linear speed and angular speed. So that, angular acceleration, centripetal acceleration is what? A is equal to V square by R. There is a formula. Substitute V as R omega, that is R square omega square by R. So R are cancelled, you can have only R omega square. Okay. So that means you can take the centripetal acceleration is resolved in two components, that is along an horizontal direction A omega square plus phi, and along the vertical direction it has A omega square sine phi. Okay. Now the projection of N centripetal acceleration is equal to A omega square sine phi. What is A? The centripetal acceleration. What is A? Radius. What is omega? Angular velocity. What is phi? Yes, it is phase. Okay. Now from the triangle OPN, suppose take this triangle OPN, we have sine phi is equal to ON by OP. Okay. But ON is equal to Y and OP is equal to A. That is the OA is OP is equal to radius. for which we can represent the letter A. Sin phi is equal to y by A. Therefore, by cross multiplication, we have y is equal to A sin phi. Okay. Yes. Y is equal to A sin phi. Just you substitute this y value in the equation number 1. What is the equation number 1? A omega square sin phi. So that A sin phi is equal to y means A is equal to omega square y. But omega is constant. Remember one thing. Suppose if a body moves, a particle is moving on circumference of a circle, its velocity changes, but its angular velocity is constant. Very, very important concept here. Yes. If a body is moving on the circumference of a circle, that is, if it's uniform circular motion, its speed is constant, but velocity is not constant. That means it has an acceleration. That acceleration is always directed towards the center. That acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. And of course, if a body is moving on this in a circular motion, it has angular velocity, omega. That angular velocity is always constant for a particle. Yes, A proportional to y. That means that omega square is constant. Okay. Hence, the projection N executes simple harmonic. Whenever the body, you know that condition, there are two conditions I already explained. If a body is executing simple harmonic motion, means the acceleration is always directly proportional to its displacement, and the displacement is always towards the mean position. Okay. If these two conditions holds good by the body, that means the body is at SHM. Yes. Whenever you can get A proportional to Y means what? The projection N executes simple harmonic motion. Similarly, we can prove that the projection M is also executing simple harmonic motion. Okay. Yes. Therefore, uniform circular motion can be described as the combination of two, that is simple harmonic motion acting perpendicular to each other. Yes. There is a simple harmonic motion of the particle on the radius, the diameters. Okay. So that is the thing. Anyway, there is a relation. That means what? From this diagram, just you observe this diagram, you can easily understand. So whenever the particle is moving on the circumference of a circle, the projection of this particle on diameters executing simple harmonic motion. Yes, we proved that the motion, that acceleration A proportional to Y means, of course, it is the formula of SHM. Okay. Yes. So displacement of the body. How you are calculating the displacement? Observe the diagram here. Here, a particle P is at t is equal to 0, that is at P on the circumference of a circle. And at the time lapse, that is if t is equal to t, then the particle is at q. Now, the projection drawn on the diameters xx dash yy dash, that projection particle executing simple harmonic motion. That's you know. Now, here, OP makes an angle phi, and this Q makes an angle omega t. So that means, suppose if you take this sector, or this sector, what is the angle here? If you take the angle omega t here, and what is the total angle? Omega t plus phi. Yes, from here to here, the angle is phi. And from here to there, that is P to Q, the angle is omega t. And then that, what is the total angle from the x-axis? Omega t plus phi. Just to go through it. Let us consider a particle is moving along the circumference of a circle of radius A. At some instant, the particle is at the point P making an angle phi with the diameter xx dash. And after t seconds, the particle reaches the point, of course it is Q. From this triangle OPN, triangle OPN, take any triangle, you can have sine omega t plus p, it is the angle, total angle, is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, that is one ON by OP. What is ON? Y. And what is OP? A, that is a radius. So therefore, by cross multiplication, we have Y is equal to sine omega t plus phi. Yes. Here this omega t plus phi is called what? Phase angle, and A is the amplitude, and of course, phi is the initial phase. Now, what is the expression for velocity? We know the displacement. What is the displacement? The equation y is equal to sine omega t. Yes. Whenever you know the displacement, you can easily calculate the velocity. The rate of change of displacement is called velocity. So v is equal to dy by dt. That means d by dt of a sine omega t. So therefore, a is a constant. Take it at outside. V is equal to a into d by dt of a sine omega t. But of course, sin omega t, differentiate, if you differentiate it, you can get cos omega t, and omega t as omega. So finally, we can have V is equal to A omega cos omega t. Understand? Just I am going to calculate the velocity of the particle, which is at a simple harmonic motion. You know the displacement, Y is equal to sin omega t. Yes. So if you take the differentiation of the displacement, you can get the velocity. By mathematical derivations, velocity v is equal to a omega cos omega t. Yes. You know the sin omega t is equal to y by a from the diagram. You know the equation cos omega t, that is what? Sin square theta minus plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, or cos theta is equal to root of 1 minus sin square theta. That is, you know this equation. In trigonometric equations. Therefore, from this, you know the cos omega t is equal to root of 1 minus sin square omega, sin omega t whole square. Cos omega t is equal to sin omega t, you know that y by a. Put the value as y by a. That is, substitute the sin omega t value, that is y by a, in this equation. That is, cos omega t is equal to root of 1 minus y by a whole square. Yes. Or otherwise, cos omega t is equal to, by taking the LCM, a square minus y square by a square. Yes. Now substitute the value of cos omega t in the equation number 2. Yes. A omega into, yes, that is what is the cos omega t? Root of a square minus y square by a square. Okay. So here a cancel. Suppose if you take it out from the root, you can get a. You can only have omega in the root of a square minus y square. From this equation, we can calculate the velocity of the particle for which it is exhibiting simple harmonic motion. Yes. Velocity is maximum at mean position, you know. That means at mean position, the displacement is 0. That y is equal to 0. Therefore, v is equal to, we have a omega. It is the maximum velocity at mean position. Velocity is minimum at extreme position. You know that the velocity of a displacement y is equal to a, by substituting these values, y as a, you can have v is equal to 0. Yes, from this equation, you can understand that if a body is moving, if a body is exhibiting simple harmonic motion, that means at extreme position the velocity is 0, at mean position the velocity is maximum. Just you recollect the oscillations of simple pendulum. It is moving its to and fro motion about its mean position. It goes to some point, the extreme point, and then it comes back. Why? Because it's at that point the velocity is 0. That means the velocity at extreme point is 0. But while it is traveling at mean position, its velocity is maximum. So that is why then it goes to other side. And their velocity is 0. And then it comes back. And then it just comes back. So in this way, the body is executing SHM. Anyway, if a body is at a simple harmonic motion, that is to and fro motion, at extreme position the velocity is zero, at mean position the velocity is maximum. It's very, very important. Now I'm going to calculate the expression for the acceleration. Yes, we know that velocity a v is equal to a omega cos omega t. From the displacement I calculate the velocity, for which it has v is equal to a omega cos omega t. Yes, now we can differentiate the velocity, then you can get the acceleration. Yes, the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. D by dt of v, that is d by dt of a omega cos omega t. Take it a omega cos omega t, d by dt of cos omega t, then you can have minus sin omega t into omega. So therefore you can have a minus a omega square sin omega t. Understand? Yes, these are all mathematical expressions. Just you write one by one equation, then you can understand. Okay. But y is equal to a sin omega t, that is displacement. Substitute the value instead of a sin omega t y, that is sin omega t is equal to y by a. Substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1. Finally, you can have a is equal to minus a omega square into y by a. A cancel. You can have a is equal to minus omega square y. Yes. This represents what? Equation of simple harmonic motion. A is equal to a proportional to minus y, or a is equal to minus omega square y. See, after calculations we got this equation. That means what? The body or the particle, which is the projection body on this diameter, is executing simple harmonic motion. Okay. So now we'll calculate the where the acceleration is maximum and where the acceleration is minimum. Now, acceleration is maximum at extreme position. It is reverse of the velocity. Yes. At extreme position, so in my previous slide, I proved that extreme position the velocity is zero. At mean position, the velocity is maximum. But here, the acceleration is maximum at extreme position. Yes. Just substitute y as a. You can have a is equal to minus omega square a. And acceleration is minimum at mean position. Yes. If y is equal to zero, that means the displacement is zero at mean position. So that acceleration is zero. So in this way, you can calculate the displacement of the body, that is y is equal to a sin omega t, velocity of the body, then v is equal to a omega cos omega t, and also acceleration. Finally, we calculate the acceleration, a is equal to minus omega square y, which it is represent the equation of the simple harmonic motion, that is a proportional to minus y. What is a? Acceleration, and what is y? Displacement. I already told you the conditions of if a body executing simple harmonic motion. There are two conditions. Remember very and try to take this points in your mind. If a body is executing simple harmonic motion, means its acceleration is always directly proportional to the displacement, and then that acceleration is always directly towards the center. Yes, if it holds good this condition, then you can say the body is executing simple harmonic motion. Okay, from all the calculation, so we got the velocity and acceleration also. Of course, the velocity, how it changes at mean position and how it changes at the extreme position. And similarly, the acceleration also calculated at extreme position, the acceleration is maximum, and at the mean position, its acceleration is minimum. Okay, so in this way, I obtain the relation between circular motion, that is uniform circular motion, and simple harmonic motion. Okay. So from this, just I start this. Students, you don't be bothered about the subject here. Explanation and the mathematical derivations are very, very important. You have to work out on the paper at least 2 or 3 times. So then only you can remember all the equations. And also, before going to that, you should know the definitions of these particular physical quantities, and also what are the equations related to each. So then only you can understand each and every point. Okay. Thank you.